In 1954, Salvador Dali completed an incredible painting of Christ on the cross. It wasn't just magnificent artwork. Dali was also trying to paint in the fourth dimension. Let me explain. You're watching this now on a flat, two-dimensional screen, but you can clearly see I exist in a deep, three-dimensional world. Is it possible, therefore, to be inside a three-dimensional world and see a fourth spatial dimension? Now, this is like asking a question like, can you think of a colour that doesn't already exist? But we can get there in stages. First of all, imagine a one-dimensional object, a line. Now, take two of them and join them together, and you get a two-dimensional object, a square. So if we join the two squares together, we can get a three-dimensional object, a cube. So it stands to reason, if we join the two cubes together, we can get an object in the fourth dimension. This is called a hypercube, but unfortunately in this three-dimensional world, I can't really draw it out properly for you. However, we can go about it in another way. If we take a three-dimensional cube, we can unwrap it to make a two-dimensional net. This is, if you like, the blueprint for the cube. All you do is you join this edge to this edge and this edge to this edge, and it folds up to make the cube. So it stands to reason, if we can unwrap a three-dimensional object to make a two-dimensional net, we can unwrap the four-dimensional hypercube to make a three-dimensional net. And that's what I've done here. Now, I've made this out of OXO cubes. You might have seen things made out of OXO cubes before. It's just stock footage. So there is the three-dimensional net of a hypercube. All we have to do now is connect each face to all the other faces, like that. But how can we physically do that? Well, that's the point. You can't. To be able to contemplate how this is possible, you'd have to place yourself in another existence, and that is what Dali has done here. Christ is painted, untarnished, on a cross, which is actually a hypercube net, placing him in a dimension which is unseen to us.